Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are doing chapter plant water relation and mineral nutrition. In that, we are doing topic plasmolysis and turgidity. When I say plasmolysis, it is removal of water from the cell, that is shrinkage of cell. And when I say turgidity or turgor pressure, it is the pressure inside cell. Today we'll be studying what is the importance of these two in a plant cell. Plasmolysis and turgor pressure both are a part of cell mechanism. When I say plasmolysis, it is nothing but the shrinkage of the protoplasm due to exoosmosis. When I say exoosmosis, it means removal of water. Exo means outside and osmosis is nothing but movement of water, due to which the shell, or you can say the cell membranes, shrink. Importance of plasmolysis, or you can say the significance of plasmolysis, is that with the help of plasmolysis, it can be demonstrated that whether a cell wall is semi-permeable or it is impermeable. Obviously, if a cell wall is semi-permeable, then only it will allow the passage or movement of material. Another significance of plasmolysis is that it helps to detect whether a cell is living or it is dead. Example, plasmolysis can only take place in a cell which is living and not in a cell which is already dead. Then what is turgor pressure? Turgor pressure is a pressure that is present inside the cell, and this pressure is due to the uptake of minerals as well as water molecules which are present inside the cell. The importance of turgor pressure is that turgor pressure determines the opening and closing of stomata. Stomata are nothing but tiny pores which are present on the surface of leaf. And when sun's heat in the form of photons falls on the leaf, stomata opens and transpiration takes place. Now, turgor pressure helps in the opening and closing of stomata. Besides that, turgor pressure helps to keep each and every molecules in a cell at distinct places. So every molecule is at distinct place and separated from each other. Also, turgor pressure helps to provide mechanical support to the cell, or you can say mechanical support to all the organelles present in the cell. Significance of turgidity or plasmolysis. Plasmolysis is basically shrinkage, or you can say shortening of protoplasm, or you can in simple language call it cytoplasm, due to exoosmosis. When I say exoosmosis, it means movement outside, which could be movement of water or movement of ion molecules. With the help of plasmolysis, we understand whether a cell is semi-permeable in nature. When I say semi-permeable, it allows certain molecules outside it, or allow the movement of certain molecules and disallow the movement of certain molecules. The permeability of a cell is checked with the help of plasmolysis. Besides this, plasmolysis also helps to check whether a cell is living or dead, since plasmolysis cannot take place in a dead cell. Obviously, how will the molecules move in and out when a cell is already dead? There will be no mechanism available for this. Turgidity basically helps in certain aspects. Turgidity is nothing but present of solute particles, or you can say various nutrients, that is salts, water, which is present inside soil. Turgidity plays an important role during ionic balance. Apart from that, turgidity, or you can say turgor pressure, basically helps to keep cell at distance places, or due to which all cells can grow at the normal distance. Besides this, turgor cell, or you can say turgidity, provides mechanical support to the non-woody part. When I say non-woody part, it means the petiole of the leaf for that matter, or you can say the fruit. It provides them support so that they can stand still at a place. Besides this, the most important function of turgidity is the opening and closing of stomata, the small pores which are present on the leaf surface, which help in the process of transpiration, that is loss of water. And turgidity helps the guard cells, the openings present on the stomata, to open, due to which transpiration can take place, whether it is stomatal, cuticular or lenticular. Precisely, stomatal transpiration is widely helped by the process of turgidity, or you can say turgor pressure. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about significance or importance of turgidity and plasmolysis, which are two of the vital functions that take place inside a plant cell. And if they're not present, certain movements or certain molecules could not enter or move outside of the cell. Even the process of transpiration would be hampered or stopped or cheesed for a certain point of time. I hope we all are clear with the concept of turgidity and plasmolysis and its importance. Thank you.